Rumor has it that medical students study up to 40 hours a week like it's a goddamn full-time job. But really, are you using that time effectively? And how much of that information is really sticking in here? So in this video, I'm going to show you how I memorize everything in medical school. Hey everyone, my name is Eunice and I'm a junior doctor working in Christchurch Hospital in New Zealand. A lot of people seem to think that to do well in medicine, you have to have this amazing memory. Look, if there's one thing that I've learned is that you really don't have to spend hours and hours to try remember everything, because you literally can't, especially not in medical school. So, if you're interested in learning how to hack your memory and make it work for you, you need to stay tuned until the end of the video. And before we get to the meat of the video, I would so appreciate if you could hit the subscribe button and show some support. Thanks guys. I'm going to share with you 8 techniques that has helped me study and memorize everything I need to learn in medical school. So this video will be split into 2 parts. Number 1 is the study tips that you need throughout the year, and then the 2nd is how to prep for exam. So I've left the timestamps as you can see, so feel free to jump in and click into what is most relevant to you. So how do I study throughout the year? Number 1, make your own notes that make sense to you. There's so much information that can be packed in one lecture. Like there could be 40 to 120 slides in one PowerPoint lecture. So I just condense them into a 1 or 2 page summary. Don't copy and paste, because then that's just passive learning and you don't actually absorb the information. So this summary means that it's so much easier to come back and learn that and revise. And I usually do this in OneNote app because you can draw on it and whatnot. Number 2 is to make connections, which is also known as the Hebbian Theory. You can connect ideas and relate them to each other. And I typically use mind maps for this. So I summarize different ideas into one A4 piece of paper. For example, to learn lung cancer, there's a couple of ideas to learn, right? There's pathology, anatomy, how it presents in a clinical case. So, and all of these are all taught in different lectures, but I've linked all of them together to see the bigger picture. So it works particularly well for medical conditions and to learn it this way. The 3rd way to study is using spaced repetition and active recall. I'm sure you've heard these 2 terms being thrown around in productivity channels and videos, but spaced repetition basically means that you are reviewing study material repeatedly over a duration of time instead of cramming it all in one sitting. And studies have shown that people actually forget 75% of what we've learned within 48 hours. So, like, how would you expect to remember everything at the end of the semester before the huge exam? And active recall is actually a proven evidence-based practice that works really, really well for memorization. So there are actually a couple of ways to practice spaced repetition. The first one, which is actually the most popular way to do this, is using flashcards. And lots of my colleagues love using Anki flashcards. I myself am lazy and I can't be bothered making them, so I like using other people's Anki flashcards online, or I just buy PassMed to practice USMLE questions. And you know, if you're willing to spend a little bit of money, you can actually save quite a bit of time. And number 2 is to use diagrams or mind maps. So I usually come back after a week or a few days after I've learned a topic, sit down, and I use an A4 piece of paper to draw together a mind map without using my notes. It can turn out pretty ugly at the start, but that's fine. You just need it to sit down and actively recall what you know and connect ideas together. Number 3 is a Feynman method, which just means that you're using lots of simple words to describe a complex idea, aka explain to a 5-year-old. It's a really good way of testing your understanding. So just grab a friend and do a Q&A session, and you can see where your gaps are, and your trusty friend can hopefully close that gap for you. And this is where study groups are super helpful. The 4th way I used to study is the Pomodero method. This is where you have time study sessions and time breaks. I would assign like a goal to each Pomodoro session, so I'm forced to focus super hard and get lots done and sussed in a short amount of time, and that does not allow for any time for procrastination. For example, like within a Pomodoro session, like in an hour slot, I'll be like, you need to finish cardiovascular system, the anatomy section. And I usually get it done, surprisingly. You can use apps or just a timer on Google is like just good enough. I find that it's best done with an accountable friend because they can keep you on track and like give you lots of shit if you procrastinate. This was introduced by a friend of mine who was 2 years my junior in college. So shout out to Susie Kwan. I hope you're doing well and dentistry is going all good. It's crunch time. It's that time of the year and the med exam is coming up in a week's time. There is a lot of information you've learned throughout the whole year that's going to be examined in this one exam. Holy shit! How do you tackle this efficiently? So if you want to know, keep on watching to learn how to ace your med school exam. Before we get to the tips though, I think it's super important to have the correct mindset. So honestly, you need to be super realistic and accept that you cannot memorize everything perfectly in medicine. You honestly just can't, and you shouldn't, because that actually is a huge waste of your time, even if you could. And besides, by now, if you've been doing the hard work, like what we mentioned above, been making your own notes, you know, studying consistently with active recall and spaced repetition, when exam comes, it really shouldn't be that scary. But here are the tips of how to make sure that your exam goes really well. So to prep for your exam, number one, I start by going through the super high yield topics. So how do you even know that something is high yield? It's either the lecturer has been hinting or you think that it comes up in past exam papers all the time. So those are high yield. I start by studying the core information and then everything around it. And I always make sure I have a high yield summary sheet for each subject when I go through like everything that we've learned throughout the year. Number two, using the Rongie method. While going through the content to make my high yield summary, I would be skimming the content to make a separate Rongie list. So this method is for noticing the things that you don't quite understand or not confident in, which is your gaps in your knowledge, and you write them on this list in red called the Rongie list. And these are topics that you need to make sure you go back and study super well on. And I usually combine my don't know list and my high yield list together at the very end. Number three, always use practice exams. So once you've done all your studying, gone through your high yield and your Rongie list, you should solely focus on the last couple of weeks leading up to the exam, doing lots and lots of practice exams. This is like the ultimate way of using active recall to test where your real gaps in your knowledge is. I personally wouldn't do this super late just before the exams because you want to add these gaps to your Rongie list to study the material properly. I would also do this in exam conditions, and then after that I will mark my exam papers with my study buddy. I think that's really important to mark these with other people's answers because, for example, like short answer questions, there's so many ways of writing an answer and, you know, different ways of structuring. So you want to learn from the best, right? So you look at a few examples and look at how the best one is written and you basically just copy and paste it. Alright, so those were my 8 tips on how to memorize almost everything you need to know in medical school. But I think the key takeaway message is, if you plan ahead and just be consistent with your studying throughout the year, when crunch time comes for the final year exam, there shouldn't be too much that you should worry about. Even just an hour or 2 hours each day of studying will make a huge difference to when your exam comes. Honestly, you'd be so surprised how much you already know before that comes along. So I hope this video was helpful, and if you like this video, please show that you do with a thumbs up and comment below. If you wish to see more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks, guys. See you later.